have time for any kind of traffic stop, right? You have to get a gift card or nothing. Normally, you got to get there. You want to get in line. Let's bring in the plane this morning. There are not any delays out there right now, so, you know, don't plan for extra time because your flight's delayed. We are going to be looking at on-time travel for a lot of spots. There's a few exceptions today. The Northwest is one of them. Seattle, we've got rain in your forecast. Buffalo, a little snow could create a few weather delays there. Boston and New York City's LaGuardia Airport. Watching for the potential of delays, we've got a northwesterly wind, and it's pretty strong and gusty, actually, and that could create some travel delays both those spots here. We'll watch for that today. Otherwise, let's talk about the snow yesterday. This is all the snow that fell yesterday, and it's cold, so anything that wasn't treated or cleared will be slippery this morning and slick. We have a little more snow coming in this morning. You can see coming over Lake Erie right now. Buffalo, you've been in and out of some light snow. Visibility ranging anywhere from about 2 to 3 miles, so nothing crazy for us in Buffalo, but you know how crazy it can get, right, in some of these snow squalls, and that potential is there today. This morning, it is mainly dry. We've got 16 degrees for you this morning in Buffalo. It feels like about zero. And then throughout the day, watch for a few snow showers developing here about midday or so. Temperatures topping out only in the low 20s. And there will be a wind chill factor through the day. So always feeling like about 5 to 10 degrees worse through today. But thankfully, not as many snow squalls like we had yesterday, which put on quite the show, Jim and Steph.
Yeah, let's talk about those snow squalls.
Yes.
Forecast for some of you here and actually warming up for others here. And that's key when, you know, our highs today are only in the 20s in the Northeast here. We're starting off with so many in the teens and even single digits, what it feels like anyway. So we warm it up today, a little more tomorrow in the Northeast. Southeast still looks good for your Friday. Couple of showers in Miami tomorrow and windy. Really windy next 3 days in Florida for various reasons. And it ramps up with our low pressure system that gets going here. The rain and the wind comes through I-10 up to I-20. The rest of the nation pretty quiet for your travel. We got a little rain coming into the Northwest. That comes down the coast here. If you're traveling to the West Coast, San Francisco, LA by Sunday, we got some rain spreading on in, and then we've got some showers. Well, showers. We've got rain. Let's take a look at the snowfall too. So we go up to the Northeast to talk travel where, yes, we do have a little bit coming in. I'll show you where. But for today, when it comes to travel, looking pretty good. Right now, we've got no delays out there. One turbulence report that came in from New England, and the winds are much less than we were dealing with yesterday. So we don't have, you know, any of those wind reroutes that had to happen where they, you know, had to change the runways around as those winds change direction. So what we're dealing with today is a little bit of lake effect. And there's been a couple of spots that have picked up a few inches, like around Constableville, that's one spot. Other than that, I mean, most of you didn't get much of anything there in terms of the lake effect. It's been few and far between. Now, we do have cold air. Temps are cold, especially up into Maine. We've got our jet stream kind of cutting right across this area. Couple of chances, too, to come in as we get towards the weekend. So first one comes in. We'll see just how much energy it has with it. We'll watch that here later today into the tomorrow. Here comes overnight tonight. This is 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, showers spreading across New York State. There'll be some snow. We're not looking for a big amount of accumulation, but there could be just a little bit out there that do make some of those roads a little bit slick. And same thing for you tomorrow morning. Keep an eye on southern New England. Everything is light. Everything is quick moving, but it's still could be frozen, and so that's always the concern with that. But then temps do warm up after that. So, I mean, you see the accumulations. We're not expecting much at all, if anything, into Boston. It's about 1 to 3 all across the I-90 corridor, but again, light and quick moving here coming on through. Then we take you into the forecast, jumping ahead, let's zooming in to Connecticut, Rhode Island, and then up into eastern Massachusetts, where we don't really have much accumulation, but we do have some chances for that getting in overnight tonight into early tomorrow morning. This is 4 a.m. and we will have some snow showers coming down. So if you're going to try to, you know, avoid the traffic by getting out early, the problem is you're going to run into the snow. Buffalo, let's look at you, because we do have some chances of snow coming in, but you look at our temperatures. You know, even if we get an inch, will we keep it around for Saturday to get that white Christmas? It seems unlikely, right? Because today temps are going to be in the 30s. We've got snow showers flying around, but not expecting a lot. And then tomorrow we are up into the mid 40s with rain showers and 40 degrees on Christmas Eve night. So today, looking pretty good. New York City, Philly, D.C. Tomorrow, Pittsburgh looks overall pretty good. Our temperatures are mild, 51 degrees. So it's not going to be an icy situation, but it could be a little rain from Detroit to Cleveland that maybe slows down some of your travel for your Christmas Eve. All right, let's talk about round two coming in. This is not the only chance. Well, if you will arrive at your holiday destination today, you might be looking forward to gathering around with your family, but they might want you to come to the table for a different reason.
We want to go now and look at the West Coast, where we've got a couple of storms lined up, three actually this week, to bring us some active weather. Los Angeles Mayor Eric Garcetti has held a news conference yesterday telling residents to be prepared for these storms. People in the southern part of the state are being asked to consider preparing sandbags for possible flooding and debris flow from recent burn areas. And rain from this first storm has now just begun. I saw a couple of minutes worth of rain already in the last hour. So let's take a look out there. Of course, skies look nice and dark and dreary. We've got a lot of clouds out here in the west. We are looking at, again, three systems to move on through. There's one scooting on through the southwest, two more lined up behind it. And we've got some pretty active times ahead with some big rain and snowmakers out there. So let's start with the first batch of what's coming in right now. You can see LA, we've got showers in the area. Up towards the Bay Area, we've got some rain. Las Vegas area showers, and then snow coming in through the southern Wasatch, and eventually that gets into the southern Rockies. The other piece of that is up here across the northwest. Now, we've had a little bit of everything in Portland, Oregon. We started off with about an inch or an inch and a half of snow, then a little freezing drizzle or freezing rain on top of that. There's still maybe some falling, and we'll watch closely around the Seattle area. We could also see some snowflakes mixed in with temperatures on the chillier side here as well. All right, so let's go back down the Sierra, where snow is expected. We will see 1 to 2 feet of snow this week across the Sierra. Also watching snow across the higher terrain in Nevada, into the Wasatch, into the southern Rockies, into the higher mountains in Arizona here as well. So the forecast looks like this. I mean, this is Wednesday. We still have rain painted on the map. Rain for San Francisco. Rain all the way down the San Joaquin Valley, all the way down into Southern California. This continues. And again, there's another system lined up behind this one. Hey, how can I forget about the weekend? This is how we don't forget about the weekend, right, Anaritas? This is how we start every Monday and every day as we get you to the weekend, and we are going to be looking for a busy week ahead. It's finally going to feel like winter. For a lot of you, it's your first day back to work after all the holidays. We are going to be looking for some chill in the air to start your week in the east, but then we warm back up again. One system after another, though, lined up in the west. You see how active it is out here. We've got three systems to come through this week. It's going to bring rain to California, mountain snow as well, and then we'll track by Friday all the mess getting into the Midwest and the Northeast. The weekend does look very busy with rain heading into maybe Boston later this evening. We'll look at that. But let's talk about this cold shot that has come on in. You can really see when we look at the satellite picture what is going on. First of all, you see these brighter clouds out here streaming off the coast. And then behind it, you see the direction that these clouds are moving, coming in from north over here, moving in towards the south and east. So that's where our air is coming from. We're getting some cold Arctic air finally making its way down here into the Northeast, and we are feeling it this morning. It's not just about the temperature. The wind chill is a factor as well. All right, so let's take a closer view of what's happening here as we see the cold air filtering in. Temperatures about 10 to 20 degrees below average. Our record warm December is over. Our holiday vacation is over. It is back to work, and it is back to winter here in the east. So let's watch as this boundary comes through. Watch what happens today. You know, Buffalo, 14 degrees right now. Saranac Lake, we're at 1. The front comes through, and you either stay the same temperature-wise, or you even lose a few degrees today. This front moving all the way into the mid-Atlantic, you see D.C., 36, that's it for high temperature. New York, 33, that's it. And with the wind, it's going to feel about 10 degrees colder out there if you're standing outside in the elements. Tomorrow morning, even colder, 11 degrees in Boston tomorrow morning. Continuing to see what happened and watch what is still happening with this river flooding across the Midwest. So 10 to 20 inches worth of rain in December. It was a record December when it came to rainfall, well above average. Departures of 5 to 8 inches above average in terms of rainfall, and that led to these record crests in many cases here on our rivers. Gauges along the Mississippi, gauges on the tributaries that led into the Mississippi, again running, if not, you know, top three when it comes to record crest, which is significant because you often find those records in the spring or in the summer. Let's look at where we are right now. Cape Girardeau on the Mississippi is finally coming down, but we're still up at record or at major flood stage. I'm going to stay that for the next couple of days. Stay right there. At Baton Rouge, interestingly, as we take a look at this one, we are seeing the water now come down the Mississippi, and we are just starting to go up into minor flood stage. We are going to watch for this trend going up at least for the next 6 days, and then we'll have to see beyond that. So our troubles, or our concerns anyway, have just begun further south. Ain't ready to work, but if you're not doing anything, that's definitely not going to work. And by the way, the number one thing you can do when you're at the beach is not get a straw. Don't use straws, because that is the number one thing that they fly into the ocean, right? You're on the beach, you've got straws, the wind takes them. So if you're near the coastline, don't use straws. All right, let's talk more about the weather. A coastline today going to be pretty wet here in the west. We've got rain up and down the eastern seaboard. Could be some snow in Seattle. System one of three to affect us this week on the west coast. Now in the east, our big story starts with a cold week. We got temperatures as cold as they've been in months, about 10 months for most spots there in the east. But then by Wednesday, and certainly by Thursday, we're going to feel a little more warm. We're going to see temperatures running back up above average. Not quite as crazy warm as it was in December, but nonetheless, warm enough that when our western systems evolve into the Midwest and into portions of the east, it turns into more rain than anything else. You can see rain in Chicago, rain in New York City, and by Saturday, there'll be some rain getting up into Boston as well. Now, there'll be some spots that do get snow, and we'll detail that here, fine-tune it, with some snow into portions of the upper Midwest, the Minnesota, into North Dakota, South Dakota. But by Sunday, our system in the east, you can see how mild it is. It is rain in New York City with a temperature of 50. A couple of hours, and all of a sudden, you had to start shoveling. Let's talk about some of the big totals that we got out of Winter Storm Nico. East Hartford, Connecticut, coming in with 19 inches. That's where we had some of that thunder snow. And I know that added, no doubt, to you guys getting so much snow at once. Merrimack, New Hampshire, 16 and a half. Springfield got 16. Islip, New York, 14.3. A new record for the day. Nashua, New Hampshire, 13.4. And Providence, Rhode Island, close to a foot, but not quite, at 11.9. All right, so let's talk about what we are, what we saw, and what we need to clean up from today. So it started across the plains. Nebraska, actually, we ended up with a couple of 8 or 10 inch totals, very localized. Most of it was just, 1 to 3 inches as it spread right across the Midwest into the Northeast. Pennsylvania amounts range from, 8 or 9 inches in some of the highlands across western Pennsylvania to 2 inches in Philadelphia. And then this thing got cranking off the coast. And we saw inches per hour happen here from New York City up to Hartford and New Haven and Bridgeport and Providence and Boston, Springfield, Worcester, you were all in it. Maine as well, and then it moved on out. All right, now we've got a little bit of lake effect to come in, and we got a next little clipper to come in, and we'll talk more about what's up next after all this snow fell from Nico. And right at 1 o'clock, the lake effect and a clipper, and a combination of both. We'll put a little bit of snow across parts of the Northeast. The lake effect will put a little bit more. Here's that one band that we're watching just to the east of Rochester, going just south of Syracuse, lighter as it gets down towards Oneonta here in central New York. Now we go back and stretch, you can see where that extent of that band is. When you get multi-lake bands, you get a better chance of getting some bigger totals, and actually when they're single bands like this too. So coming off of Lake Huron and then right over Lake Ontario, we're getting that. Now we've got some more snow coming in with our next system. This is a clipper coming in, very light, barely reaching the ground in most spots here, but we'll keep an eye across lower Michigan into Indiana. We might get a little bit of light snow out of this, stretching on through parts of western New York, Buffalo, into New England. Again, you could get another light coating. You might not even notice it on top of what you have already out there. But again, more snow falling on the roads, actually, most importantly, light, very light accumulations possible as we watch this into Saturday morning. So Friday night, Saturday morning for you in the Northeast, Albany, New York. You guys really started everything, I feel like, yesterday. You got that band that set right up over the Albany area, and it was just dumping snow at 4 inches per hour. Now, let's talk about what's next, because the clipper is not such a big deal for you, but the next storm, Sunday night into Monday, could be. So let's track that. So as we get into the end of the weekend, we're going to have our jet diving down across this area. Upper level, low up here, we'll sort of keep things cyclonic, and we'll continue to watch the pieces of energy pop on through. We get a low that develops right off the coast again, and strengthens and has access to moisture over the Atlantic. So now with the cold air in place, a little bit different than last time, right? We already have the cold air here. We're going to see the snow come in here. With the track of this particular low pretty far north, we're going to see that accumulating snow pretty far north as well. You can see it's all north of New York City. Philly, D.C., you're not even worried about it. And this next one, it's rain for you. All right, but snowfall in the cards for Portland, across Keene, New Hampshire, Concord, Manchester. You've all got it Sunday night. We may mix
a little bit with some rain in Portland and Boston, but then changing back over to snow when it's all done here as that low starts pulling away and more cold air all the way down to the surface starts coming in. So Boston, get ready for more snow. Monday could be another snow day, guys, out there for you in Boston. We've got the snow coming in, potentially big accumulations, especially up into Maine and maybe even into southeastern New England. So this is Sunday night and about 15 degrees colder than yesterday, starting the day in the teens, feeling sub-zero here in Boston. So this is the wind chill all across the area, and that's really what matters, right? As you go out this morning in Binghamton to walk the dog, it feels like 2 below, 10 in New York and 12 in Philadelphia. So as we get you through today, it's going to be a cold day, you know, especially with the snowpack. That's going to help keep things cold out there. Temperature-wise, we're going to warm up into the 20s. Wind chill-wise, we're not going to warm much out of the teens in Boston. So that's what it feels like all day today and overnight tonight. Now, we notice these south winds coming in. So we do get to warm up in spots, and especially where we don't have a lot of snowpack generators, we have a better pattern. Where today we're going to see the cold stick around in the Northeast, of course, cleaning up that snow. A clipper coming in from the Midwest to the Northeast. Not a big deal snow, but a little bit of snow gets to New England by this evening. And then, of course, in between that, there's some lake effect to talk about. Cold starts your day in the Southeast, warming up by afternoon. Temperatures get to the 60s in Atlanta to 70 tomorrow as we warm up all across the Southern Plains and a good chunk of the East, too. I mean, look at New York City and Chicago, a big turnaround. You're back to the 40s. Dallas, as you just heard, you're in the 80s. But Denver, you see signs of this change coming. You'll go from 70s today to 50s tomorrow. So we are going to see a marked dip in our jet stream coming in, digging in across the Intermountain West and then right across the middle of the country. Dallas, mid-60s on Sunday. Look what happens by the time we get into your Monday. We've got cold air filtering back in. We don't go that far in this. It's only the weekend. But anyway, cold air filtering back in here to the plains, and that will help get our system going in the Northeast. Mm-hmm. It was just an unfortunate accident. You know, the kind of snow that we had in the Northeast was very heavy, very wet snow for most of you. And so when you're shoveling, even, you know, regardless of what kind of snow it is, your blood pressure is going to increase. The danger is that the cold, too, is a factor because that constricts your blood vessels. And the combination of both the exertion of the lifting of the snow and the fact that it's cold out and your blood vessels are constricted, that increases the threat of a heart attack, and especially someone already prone to heart disease and a heart attack here is especially at risk. Now, before you shovel, it's important to be ready for it. You want to warm up, actually, just like you're going out to exercise, because this is exercise. Wait at least 30 minutes after you wake up to go out to shovel. Let your body wake up, let your muscles warm up, right, and get ready to go out there and do this. What is, you know, actually a workout. It's a workout. In fact, some cases harder than most workouts that people do. So we urge caution today to go out there and continue cleaning up from the, 10 to 20 inches of snow that we got in the Northeast. Now, snow wasn't the only problem with the totals of snow that we got. We've got East Hartford, Connecticut coming with 19 inches. You guys were one of the big winners. You had rounds of not just snow, but thunder snow that set up shop right here, and that helped give us those really big snowfall rates per hour that added up. Merrimack, New Hampshire, we had 16.5, Springfield, 16, Islip, new record, 14.3, Nashua, 13, and Providence, Rhode Island, Anna Ritz's hometown, 11.9 inches of snow. Her family's busy shoveling out today as well. All right, so let's look at what's coming up next. We have the lake effect snow happening right now with that cold air moving over the still unfrozen lakes, which is another story in of itself, how unfrozen the Great Lakes are right now. Now, we're going to be looking at this through today being a story, at least through the early afternoon. Lake effect snow advisories are in effect. South of Buffalo, we got a couple of unorganized little bands, but then this one more steady band sort of stealing the show. Not terribly heavy, but east of Rochester, you're going to get several inches of snow out of that. Then we take a look at what comes next. So I will say in between the lake effect and this, there's a clipper tonight that comes through, drops a little bit of a light coating of snow through New England. But then we really have to look ahead to Sunday into Monday for the next storm system. A low that's going to track on through, upper level energy will help it develop right off the coast of here of New England. It's farther north than our last one, so that will keep everything farther north. And also, I will tell you the temperatures warm up too. So we're not looking at New York City or Philly for snow out of this, but we are keeping an eye on Boston and certainly farther north, the potential for some bigger, heavier snow. With this thing, again, really developing off the coast, strong low, access to moisture. That's a recipe for a lot of snowfall. So look at this, Sunday into Sunday night. This is when things really start to go down. We've got this low pressure developing now right over here. And so now it's throwing back moisture. And where there's cold air, it will stay all snow. And for most of Maine and Vermont and New Hampshire, it's going to be all snow. Portland will spend some time switching back and forth. Boston will spend some time switching back and forth to rain and snow, but then ending as snow by Monday morning. The potential for some very heavy snow across Maine
and then into, say, New Hampshire, and then into interior parts of Massachusetts. Heavy amounts expected by Monday.
That's one of my favorite things that we've done, really, to describe that. And we are de-icing this morning, actually, de-icing at Canton-Akron Airport in Ohio, also Rochester, New York. Oh, almost got clipped by this plane, though, that made it in on time. Most flights are, actually, on time arrivals right now. Watching D.C. for about 15-minute arrival delays, and that's just volume. The wind so far has been okay in the Northeast airports, although it is a northwest flow, which is it's a tough wind for Newark and LaGuardia, so we'll see if we do keep things on time there today. Otherwise, D.C. is one of the spots we'll watch. Volume, a reason why. Looking at the wind, perhaps, is an issue around places like Wichita, and we've got Oklahoma City out there with a windy day, too. The wind can cause more issues than you think. You look outside and think it's a beautiful, sunny day. There'll be no travel delays. The wind can be a problem. Portland, we've got some rain coming in, and so that will be something that we contend with maybe some delays there. Now, let's talk what else is happening out there at the airports. We're also watching just a little bit of shower activity in the Southwest, and I really do mean a little. We're not expecting a big deluge. You might not even get anything measurable in terms of rain, but it has been so dry for so long, so your drive to the airport, right, if you get a little bit of rain, maybe your windshield's kind of dirty, dusty, make sure you have that extra windshield wiper fluid in your vehicle. It's ready to go, and in terms of any travel out here, we're good to go right now. We're not expecting any major delays. Just keeping an eye on what changes later today into the north and west. All right, so overall across the nation, we do have on-time travel for your Tuesday. We do know that volume is going to be ramping up today and getting into tomorrow. It's been a busy one. More than 2 million people again screened at airport security yesterday, so every day it's been another big mass of people coming in and going through the airports. So luckily, the weather is cooperating. We have on-time conditions right now all across the Northeast. There is that de-icing happening, the Canton-Akron Airport that I mentioned, and that might cause just a brief departure delay, but overall, not expecting anything major out there. We'll have to see how the wind affects us tomorrow in places like Chicago through Florida. That's nice to see, right? We need a break from the humidity. We're also going to be watching this rain track out of the Carolinas. Now, right now, we still have some yet to go right around the Triangle area over towards the Cape Hatteras. We've got steady rain. Charleston, big news for you. Overnight at 1:30 a.m., you now set your wettest year on record. Seemed like that was an easy thing to do right after all the rain we had back in October. But we did it, and now we got a little more rain left to go before we dry out today. And then we go down to Tampa. The heaviest of the rain now south of town, going to track down through Fort Myers and eventually Naples. That's all with that front. The same front that brought all the big changes, the temperature changes to the southeast. The front's on the move, and there's such a difference between Jacksonville and Panama City right now. Panama City, your dew points are down into the 40s. It is dry out there. It's clearing out. Jacksonville is still kind of humid, and dew points are up near 70. But once the front moves through, and it will overnight tonight into tomorrow, we'll get the moisture farther south, and we'll get the rain farther south, and we'll get some dry air moving in to the Sunshine State. So how's this how your travel looks? And I know a lot of you, today, this is it, right? You're going to wrap up work today. You're going to hit the road and take the kids to grandma's house. We've got some pretty good conditions for travel, we think, getting into Sunday. Today's going to be the wet day, and we'll hang on to a little more rain tomorrow in Central and South Florida. All right, let's talk about the chill coming in, Reynolds. It was crisp out there this morning, I thought. All right, it's Friday, everyone. Throw everything on the floor. Just get the day started, right? Here, don't bother cleaning up before you leave the house. It is the weekend, practically. But we've got your weather maps for you right here, and watching the cool air come in to give us finally a taste of real December. Yes, temperatures are seasonable. It's not cold by any means. It's just seasonable out there, but it's going to feel a lot cooler compared to what we've had lately. That means temperatures in the 20s and 30s to start our day up here in the Northeast. With the cold air coming in over the Great Lakes, we've got a chance of lake effect snow, and this could be a really big deal for us, especially off of Lake Ontario right into the Plug Hill Plateau, where we could get nearly a foot of new snow. And Jim Cantore is calling it some thunder snow. We'll chit chat about that today. We're also going to take a look at the warmth ahead for next week. So yeah, we have some cool air coming in, but it's not going to last, and temperatures going right back to above average throughout next week, including into Christmas Day. Welcome back, everyone. It is 30 minutes past the hour. AMHQ continues right here. Cantore looking ahead to
The thunder snow thing, since you brought it up.
The camera perspective, but the radar showing us the rain is about over. It happened at 1:30 last night, though, in Charleston, when we got just enough rain to tip us over into the wettest year on record. I mean, I think for a lot of folks, it's no surprise, considering what happened in October with that big, big rain, more than a foot or foot and a half of rain. But now, as we take a look at where the rain is, Charleston, we're going to dry out. The afternoon will be dry and sunny. We've got rain up there in eastern North Carolina for now, but that moving out Where we'll stick the showers around for a lot of the day is in central and southern Florida. The front on the move. Tampa, we've had some bouts of heavy rain already. You can see showers still yet to come through. The front not through yet. Jacksonville, the front is through, though, back towards Panama City. And when you step outside today, it feels a lot different. Dry air has moved in, and that dry air is actually going to make progress all the way down through South Florida. Something we haven't seen much of this season, right? We have not had those classic, beautiful November, December days where the skies are nice and blue and it doesn't feel sticky outside. We will get that. We'll get that this weekend. We'll get the rain out of here. And in fact, this weekend, I think, looks great for travel through the southeast. Thanks to this front moving on through. Yes, it'll be cooler, but it'll be dry. And Sunday travel looks great through the southeast. All right, but speaking of the chill, let's talk more about it with Reynolds. So certainly something to watch. Now, let's look at the here and now when it comes to travel and, you know, the holidays. You know, for all intents and purposes, kick off this weekend as folks wrap up the school for the first half of the year and they get their kids out on the road. We are going to look for some snow. Now, Saturday's forecast calls for some lake-enhanced snow or lake-effect snow right here off of Lake Michigan. And in western Michigan, lower Michigan, you know how it gets sometimes. The visibility drops so dramatically, so quickly, and it can change rapidly, especially with lake-effect snow. So be ready for that. I always worry about the roads up here. Then we look at Sunday's forecast, and there'll be a couple of spotty rain showers across portions of the upper Midwest. Temperatures will be starting to come back up at this point and starting that warming trend that Jim was just talking about. Southern Plains, talking travel for you, looks very good. Today into tomorrow, we're going to see it nice and quiet and dry. Little rain comes, though, back in by Sunday, and that'll affect Interstate 40, potentially down into Interstate 20. Anna Rittis. On AMHQ, vacation's over, and for many of you, that means it's time to get back to work. You could run into rain and storms as you head out the door from Texas to Pennsylvania. We're tracking this rain as it moves out. Can't see anything in the skyline. Very soupy, very warm. Dew points are up. All the reasons why we've got a lot of fog in the southeast. And out ahead of our front today, it's going to be warm as we see those winds still from the south, bringing up the moisture, but also bringing up the warm air. Now, let's take a look at things out there today, temperature-wise. Still running well above average across the south and east. Behind the front, while you're cooling down, it's not going to be cold by any means, but just closer to average. Actually, still above average for some of you, just closer to average. With the front itself, we've got some showers, some thunderstorms actually moving through Middle Tennessee right now. We see some of that moving through parts of Arkansas, getting into Mississippi and northern Louisiana right now. We'll track the front through. The front itself with the moisture kind of falls apart as it moves more to the south and east. So we won't see a ton of showers and storms today. There will be a few more. What you'll notice is some drier air coming in behind it and some relatively cooler temperatures coming in as well. So here's that rain, couple of showers maybe getting into the Atlanta area, Birmingham, it's possible through the afternoon. This is 2, 3, 4, 5 o'clock, a couple of showers into South Alabama, Southern Mississippi, and maybe around New Orleans area. But you notice how things really break up. It's not going to be the amount of rain like we got in Arkansas yesterday. Things really do certainly weaken as it moves into the south and east. But behind the front today, temperatures are only going to be in the 50s in Nashville. It's a lot different than the 70s we've seen, right, the past couple of days. Little Rock only in the 50s. Atlanta will hit 69 today before the front comes in. We're still in the 80s in Florida, Tallahassee, and in Tampa. Meanwhile, in the north, it's just as warm. In fact, even warmer in places like Boston this morning. And that wrapped up in North Dakota, Midwest. Also had a lot of rain, especially in parts of Kentucky and Ohio. Let's look at Louisville, because now we're behind the front. Louisville, we're in the 40s right now. Feels like it's in the 30s. Big difference. We're not going to see temperatures warming up a whole lot more than this today. And actually, did you know, Louisville is home to the largest urban forest in the country, 6,500 acres. A lot of trees out here today as we take a look at maybe some rustling in the wind behind that front. It's breezy. It's not windy, but it's breezy. All right, so here we go with temperatures really dropping off behind our front, losing about 20 to 25 degrees in Chicago and Indy and Louisville. But you saw Louisville, 41 degrees is actually not bad for late December. So it's not that it's freezing behind the front. It's just that it's cooler than the crazy warm, record-breaking temperatures that we had yesterday. Like Cincinnati yesterday, we were in the 70s. We broke a record. 71 degrees, I think, was our high. And so now today, we're not going to be as warm there. We'll find out temperatures are a lot lower this morning. And while we'll warm up a couple degrees today, we're not going to budge a whole lot, going to only 42 degrees in places like Cincinnati. All right, good morning, everyone. We throw the maps on the floor and get your day started. It might be back to work for you. We've got to look at that weather across the country this week. Still the warmth hanging on for at least another day. Temperatures are going to hit records for a few spots, I think, today, although just above average for so many. In the east, too, where we start off very mild this morning, but our next system coming in with snow. How much? Who will get it? And how much lake effect will we get behind it? It's all part of the big story right here on AMHQ. Thanks for joining us on this Tuesday morning. It's kind kind of back, you know, back to normal, I feel, a little bit like today. Yesterday, you know, it was a holiday for so many.
Right.
And the wind is from the south, so that's going to contribute to temperatures being warm again today, anywhere ahead of the front. Behind the front, you've got that northwest flow, and that's going to dry us out a little bit, bring in some drier air with lower dew points. It'll feel better because it's been kind of humid, right? We're also going to see some cooler temperatures behind the front as well. And with the front itself, there'll be some showers and maybe even some thunderstorms. Until the front goes through, it's going to be warm. And, you know, this isn't a huge, strong front. It's not like it's going to drop, you know, back down to freezing, but it is going to drop about 20 degrees behind the front. You'll see that in just a few minutes. But here around the Roanoke area, warm temperatures running 20 plus degrees above average. Atlanta, Columbia, Greenville, all going to see the warmth of the southerly winds out ahead of the front. Plus, with the front itself, though, there'll be a couple of showers, a couple of thunderstorms this morning, southern Arkansas, northern Louisiana. You heard the thunder last night in Middle Tennessee, and now that front is moving through. So your temperatures aren't going to move that much today in places like Nashville. We'll gain a couple of degrees, but not like yesterday. You're not hopping in the pool today, I can tell you that. All right, so watch the front come in with these rain showers. This is our forecast model, and you'll see some showers out there today. The front kind of breaks up a little bit as it gets into the southeast, and we're not going to see a lot of additional big thunderstorms. There'll be a couple of showers from time to time. Maybe bring the umbrella along today, but don't think you're going to need it all day. It's not a washout of the day. It's truly hit or miss showers out there. And warm. Temperatures hit 69 in Atlanta and 71 in Jackson. Birmingham will be right there as well. Still very warm in Tallahassee, hitting 80 again, and mid-80s for you in Central Florida. Look at Tampa. Tomorrow, we're 81 degrees there. And behind the front tomorrow, we'll see temperatures getting back closer to average, but still actually a little above average, even behind the front. Now, the thing about this front is all the way into the northeast, we've got temperatures that are warm this morning, even warmer than the south, Jackie.
Yeah,
that's on the floor. Show you everything going on out there today. And yes, we're going to go one more day here with above average temperatures, well above average, I should say, and potential record breaking. We stay warm, though, through the week. We have the next system tracking in, and actually, because we're staying warm, it might be more rain than snow along the coast, but we've got to look at the details on this one, and behind it, there will be lake effect snow. So if you're a skier, we'll be looking at some new snow coming on in here into the end of the week, especially New Hampshire, Vermont, Maine, looking great for snow.
Yeah, the mountains looking good. The skiers looking hopefully good. Yes. Looking happy. Yes.
And travelers, it's actually something for everybody.
Yeah, I know. But
good morning to you. Want to start just by setting the stage with these new products or with the renewed energy credits. Is it good enough to just buy the products, or do you have to buy the products and install them before the end of the year, before December 31st? What would be some of the easiest ways to take advantage of the tax credits? About claiming the credits could possibly save just, you know, based on the tax, you know, and purchase and install and keep on going as well. Kristen Sharp from Energy Star there at the EPA. Thank you. And to start your forecast here beyond that, then thunderstorms continue on Thursday. We will be drying out into Texas, but we see the storms moving to the south and east, and watching for that as we get you into your Friday. There's two systems by the time we get to Friday. Two systems, one off the coast, another one dropping into the upper Midwest here. And then what happens as we get into the weekend with these two systems? That's a big forecast challenge, and an interesting one at that, for the Northeast. Okay, Saturday's forecast is a dry one, but is there the chance of a little snow into Boston? Do we get a big coastal storm? Is it close enough to actually throw some snow back into cities like Boston? Those are one of the many questions here. And it is definitely a difficult forecast getting into the end of the weekend. Next week, we started all over again.
Yes.
This winter, it feels like a relentless storm track for them. Speaking of relentless, the rain has been. Let's bring in the plane this morning. I want to show you where you could see some delays due to the rain that we are going to have this week in the south. Yet again, we've got thunderstorms and rain. Atlanta area keeping a watch on the low clouds and the rainfall out there. So far, so good in Atlanta. And, you know, Atlanta can handle some rain. They got a bunch of runways, right? But just things can get backed up when you have big thunderstorms in the area. Today, those thunderstorms could be more likely back towards West Tennessee, including around Memphis. So that's where we'll watch for delays. Keeping watch on that rain in Atlanta and Birmingham. Memphis likely to see some delays. Nashville, too. By this evening, we could see some thunderstorms. And Lexington, windy and rainy. So potential delays there. If you are traveling today in the east, let's take a quick look. Look at what's happening now. Most of this isn't touching the ground. I did take a look, but I didn't see any snowfall reports out here. But if you see anything, it should be pretty light. It's really about the rain coming in. So if you're traveling on 70, if you're traveling on 64, if even 80, it's rain. And rain is going to be coming up, moving from south to north. We've been watching that this morning. And actually, Indianapolis, we've had rain. Fort Wayne, it has been a rainy start to your day. But this is pushing east. So if you just wait a little bit, you'll be out of the rain for your commute. But you're going to get into it in Cleveland and Pittsburgh lunchtime. Couple showers out there as well, and we'll see some rain right on 64 heading towards Charleston by the commute home from work today. Steph and Jim?
Well, winter was much,
actually, and I love dew points, and I think they're so useful, and I'm going to show you why they're really useful in forecasting severe weather. So we look at the water vapor, because this shows us where there's moisture in the atmosphere. The water vapor, we can look at the low levels, the mid levels, or the upper levels here. This showing us the mid levels of the atmosphere, the brighter colors indicating more moisture. But then how do you measure that? How do you put a number on it? Well, relative humidity is the ratio of vapor pressure to the saturation vapor pressure with respect to water. What? Basically, it's comparing temperature to dew point, and when they're close together, you have a higher relative humidity. And it doesn't matter if it's cold or if it's warm, but when they're close together, you have a higher relative humidity. And that's what we have right now. Dallas and Memphis and St. Louis all have different temperatures and different dew points, but in all these cities, the temperature and the dew point are close together. Now, how about dew point? Well, that's the temperature at which an air parcel is cooled in order for saturation to happen. Basically, the temperature where dew is going to form, right? So now we start to understand a little more about what the atmosphere feels like when you know dew points. The dew point in Dallas is near 60 degrees. So that's kind of a warm spring morning, right? But the dew point in Atlanta is 36 degrees. That air is pretty dry out there. And of course, we'll be looking at that when we look at this upcoming forecast. You need higher dew points for